our food is zero spiced. We don't put any spices. And then for the vegetables also, it has given our customers that opportunity to try out and sample like different kinds of vegetables. Like what we're doing right now in the restaurant, we offer at least a variety of vegetables whereby people can come and test and say, okay, fine, I've never had this, let me try this. I've never tried this, let me try that. And then I realized, so this is what people have been missing. And so that kind of response has enabled us to keep growing and to keep growing up to the level where we are right now. My name is Miriam Nabakwe, CEO and founder of Kijiji Store. I come from Western Kenya, from Bunyore. I started this business in 2014 as a home-based business. And initially, I started with selling vegetables. Whereby I thought about this idea of coming up with business which I can be able to offer convenience to people and they enjoy their nutritious food back at home. So what did I do? I actually started sourcing for the vegetables from pure organic farmers from Western Kenya. And then I realized that, okay, I want to eliminate the processes of plucking the vegetables, washing and doing the initial cooking, because also these vegetables are done in a special way. And I thought about it and I felt probably let me begin that. And since 2014 up to now, here we are in Kijiji Store. First of all, I'm a self-driven person, very hands-on, and I'm very proud to say that I'm the head chef of this business. I have taught my cooks how to produce this food, and I have a background in hospitality management, whereby I've worked in several establishments as a food and beverage manager. Now, one thing that really inspires me is to the fact that everywhere I worked, I left a track record, a very good record, and every work I did, I mean, every employer that I worked for, I always used to take that work like it is my own. I'm translating the knowledge that I learned in college and with my different employers to this, and the same character and attitude that I did, I mean that I used to perform with my employers, that's the same thing that I'm doing with my own business. Actually, I opened during the COVID time and there was a lot of uncertainty, especially in the business space. And I can say one way or another, having worked from home, I had already developed my client base, and most of the customers could identify with me because of a lot of marketing that I did on social media. COVID happened, it left a lot of people helpless, it left a lot of people off balance, but we cannot now keep dwelling on that. We have to rethink and see, think fast and see how can we reorganize ourselves, how can we re-strategize ourselves to get back to business. And there are so many options. We cannot tie ourselves only to that. I keep saying that. There's a lady who came to me and she was really struggling, she had closed. I told her, why don't you start selling dawa, ginger, lemon, garlic and what have you. And she started doing those concoctions and now she's stable. She's doing it from her home, the comfort of her home, and she's selling online and it's working for her. I think what I can say is sometimes think out of the box. Think out of the box, and you have to be heavy on your marketing. You have to be out there for people to know what you're doing. So you'd find that if you got into this business like with something ordinary, I mean, you lose relevance. We have plans to expand, and my biggest plan is to franchise. Why do I want to franchise? It's because I feel I cannot be able to run different stores everywhere. But I believe I can be able to manage different stores with proper standard operating procedures in place and having trained people who are running the franchises so that we take this food to different places. So now, how do I take this knowledge to the next generation? The best way is now to do the franchises. And then secondly, set up a training school whereby I can be able to now monitor that. So when these people want to come and set up their franchises, they have a space where they can be trained properly. And I already have a commissary right now which is running. A commissary is like a central production area whereby the food is controlled from one place, it is produced from one place, so the quality of the food is maintained. So If I am the one supplying these franchises, then the quality of food across the board will be the same. There's a point in life whereby things didn't go right for me and I was auctioned, I lost everything. I did not look at myself and say, okay, fine, I'm living in Hurlingham, I want to, you know, I would have been broken and completely out of business. But I picked myself and I said, I'll go and stay in Kawangware. I stayed in Kawangware for 2 years. I picked myself up, here I am. So it's a matter of not giving up and believing in yourself and knowing where you're going and focusing. And then there's something else called consistency. You have to be very consistent and you have to be very deliberate with what you do because you know where you're going, you know what you want to achieve. So that is the best inspiration I can give someone out there who feels like they are down, who feels like they closed. I talk to people, there are people who come to me and tell me, what do I do, what do I do? I mean, and I offer advice like, this is what you should do, try this, try that. You have to keep trying. You cannot just give up and say, okay, fine, it happened, it happened. If it's a bad location, look for another one. Look for a smaller one, downsize, and see if things can work for you. You don't have to be in a very big space.